So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a detailed history, of course. I'm going to go through their medications and make sure that I don't have any offending agents, right? So, you know, in terms of the Parkinson's world, you know, shorter acting medications, dopamine agonists are culprits. If a person is taking dopamine agonists several times per day, maybe using an extended release one would be a better choice. Anything extended release is better than the pulsatile ones.
For this,
to reduce the symptomatology. Also, people will have more symptoms in the morning. So that's traditionally what happens with people with nOH. So their symptoms are going to be much worse in the morning and typically get much better as the day progresses. And you may have symptoms after eating. And that's because the arteries and veins in the stomach, they pull the vasculature, the blood to there. So I will ask them these kinds of things. And also, do your symptoms get better once you sit down? So that's another pearl. Does the symptoms get better? So then, yes, of course, I'm going to do my orthostatic blood pressures. I'm going to take the blood pressures. I'm going to have the person lay down in my office for 5 minutes. And then I'm going to have them stand up. I'm going to take a blood pressure and a heart rate after 1 minute, and then take it again after 3 minutes. And then I'm going to see, is there a drop on either the systolic or the diastolic of either 20 millimeters of mercury or 10? And then another thing that is important to recognize in nOH is that the heart rate does not increase. So if it's just regular OH for one of those other reasons, the heart rate is going to increase. And in nOH, it does not. So it will be blunted. And so that's another diagnostic pearl for us to look at.